You're listening to the Electronic Media Collective Podcast Network. Yeah, it's a mouthful. For more great shows, like the one you're about to enjoy, visit electronicmediacollective.com. And now, our feature presentation.
Everybody, welcome to Awesome Sunday Show. Connor here.
And Pat.
So today is a very special episode. So again, we're not going to have a dad-ass report for you. So all the news and comic and movie and TV related and video game related entertainment will be coming again next week. Because, like I said, we have a very special episode. Pat, what's in 4 days? 3 days.
Hanukkah.
Hanukkah. Well, that's in 2 days. That's sundown.
Yes. Christmas, I
Christmas,
think.
Christmas, yeah.
Well, you know.
Christmas.
I don't think so. Yeah, I don't celebrate. I choose not to celebrate.
Yeah.
No.
So we have some very special guests for a very
I stopped celebrating once, you know, Starbucks made those offensive holiday cards. I was so outraged. Because how could they? With such a... Phil, I'm surprised you don't feel the same because you're a basic bitch.
Wait, people don't know he's here yet.
It's basic bitch Phil.
It is. All right.
Dude, fuck Hoffman.
All right, so we have a very special episode.
Say fuck Hoffman?
Oh, got him.
All right, and we also have to do something else. We're going to say special a lot this episode because it's a special episode about Christmas specials, not Christmas movies. That was last year with Dan Spikowski. If you want to know our favorite Christmas movies, be sure to check out that episode. It's a very good episode with a very good guest, Dan.
I will link it in the description.
Thank you, Pat. So we're going to talk about our favorite Christmas specials, whether it's just like a made...
Well, TV episode specials. There is a difference.
TV episode specials or specials made for TV.
TV episodes or specials.
Or specials. Okay. That's a better way to put it. So we brought some very special guests, and we're going to have them introduce themselves.
Not
ladies
one.
First.
Not two, but three.
Yeah. I have to say ladies first because these guys will jump ahead right over because they're so rude.
They do have vaginas.
I'm Sarah.
Seriously, I was promised like free appetizers coming here. It's like yet to be anything. Like, where's the food? I'm Anthony Dentino. It's great to be back.
Damn, Anthony, you've been busy. You were just live from the Middle Urinal courtesy flush.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, it's just been real busy. I had to shave my head this morning. I shaved my head yesterday. And then I brushed my teeth with a wiener dog.
Oh, God.
How do I follow that?
Yeah, don't.
We already introduced you.
Yeah. Hey, guys.
Jingle, jangle, jangle, jangle. It's me, Phil.
Hey, guys. It's Phil from live from Middle Urinal. Anthony Dentino looks like a thumb. And you guys forgot that Festivus is tomorrow.
Well, you know, that goes without saying.
Oh, so it's Nick from the right urinal. I'm here today. It's
not the left.
But okay,
you hang to the right.
Before we get into the episode,
you gotta go how you sway. Yeah.
Before we get into the episode, I want to know what the listeners think because I thought of an awesome podcast for Nick Vandermas, who is sponsoring you guys. Right? Is that a thing or is it
Gallivant? Yes.
Gallivant. Yeah. And then congratulations and Nick Snyder.
Present.
Yeah. You guys, I always wanted you guys to start your own podcast. Called.
Yeah, it should happen, honestly.
Yeah, I thought of it. It was called Nick's at Night.
Ooh, I like it.
And it's Nick Snyder and Nick Vandermas. They review whatever they want to review. So okay. It could be anywhere from a movie, a TV show, a candy bar.
I listen.
An adult video.
Oh, maybe not.
Property sex.
Hold on. I want to see the review like Reese's Peanut Butter Cups and Nick sit there like, I can't review it. I can't eat it.
I'll die.
Or any type of Chinese food.
Wait, I didn't know you were allergic.
That joke is so 1999.
Yes, Nick is deathly allergic to peanuts.
Yes. Yeah.
You're that kid from Freaks and Geeks?
Class moms hate me. Always hated me. I am Bill Haverchuck. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Man, I'm glad you were not in my classes. Yeah. That's probably why Dentino actually hates you.
I think that's it.
Even
yeah.
though you
Dentino lived off peanut butter for like 8 years of his life.
I rejected his mom's cupcake once, and we just never looked at each other the same.
Yet, his mom hates Phil instead of you.
Well, yeah, I had a red wig on that day. So. That kind of
one. That would help.
God damn it.
Phil, you're wearing a very appropriate shirt.
I am.
Yeah.
Well, not for this episode, well, but for what you did before.
Yeah.
I was just on the casting couch review.
Yeah.
And we reviewed Rogue One.
Don't worry, dude. Your acting career is going to take off now.
Yeah.
I was an actor as a kid.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Didn't you act in a Heinz ketchup commercial or something?
Coca-Cola? Yeah. And I was also runner-up to be Frankenstein in Big Daddy. They only picked the other kids because they're twins and it was easier for them to split the role. I met Adam Sandler and everything, too. And I also did the scene in Central Park where he throws a stick.
Phil was in a terrible Heinz ketchup bottle accident. That's why he is red. A lot of people don't talk about it now, but I think we should just raise awareness because that's what the Wake Me Up Challenge is about. Follow me on Instagram.
Since when are you putting plugins on our fucking show?
Hey, let him do what he wants.
Yeah, hey, this is a free country.
I'll
right?
allow it.
All right.
I can't.
All right, so let's get back into what we really brought everybody around here for. Our favorite, yeah, our favorite or just Christmas specials that we really enjoyed growing up as children, or maybe recent ones that we might have seen that struck a nostalgic or comedic chord with us. I have a particular favorite that I would like to bring up. I don't know if any of you guys have particular favorite ones, but I would like to hear
particular.
I'd like to hear like the ones that you've enjoyed over the years. But also, too, I got to give credit where credit's due. This is Pat's idea, this episode. And I thought it was a very good idea.
It is a good idea.
But thank you.
It is a good
something.
Idea.
Okay.
Who thought of all the Oscar episodes?
Okay, so that's
see, you two? And I are on the same page. Yeah. We think of the cool shit, and him and Matt just...
You don't think do of anything shit. Cool.
Dude, they look at their TV guide and go, yeah, I could do that.
Do you know how many times I come over here and Connor goes, so what are we recording about?
That's dumb.
Okay. Gosh. Oh, no. That's okay. I do that all the time, but you always like 89% of the time you reply, I don't fucking know.
And then I look at my phone, I go, okay, we can do this.
Yeah. This is a great way to enjoy. We're airing grievances right now. Yeah.
Exactly.
This is Where's Festivus?
The poll? The
oh, it's over there. Yeah. Connor has a Sherpa pole in his basement.
I do, but no, anyway, so tradition at Awesome Sunday Show. We always let this very special guest go first. I would normally say ladies first, but I don't know how.
It's okay.
Yeah. Do you want to go first, though?
She also has the least amount of appearances, so I think.
Yeah, she should go first.
Unless you don't want to. It's not.
Yeah,
pressure.
I don't want to force
I can go
you.
First. I don't mind. I'm okay. I'll say one, and then we can go from there. How about that? Is that good?
I'd love to
All right.
That.
I'll say my favorite. Wait, you guys don't watch Supernatural, right? I know you don't. You never seen Supernatural?
I've seen it here and there. I never like watched it a lot.
Well, my number one probably Christmas episode is in Supernatural, which is like about two brothers, which it kind of stinks that you never seen it because it's not as...
I know what it's about.
You do? Okay.
Two brothers.
Yeah.
How does the Rick and Morty thing go?
Oh, I don't know off the top of my head.
All right, forget
Mexican
it.
Mexican Armada in space.
And they go off like the pagan folklores and how Christmas is pretty much like a pagan holiday. And a lot of the rituals are like pagan kind of rituals, I guess.
They're of pagan ancestry. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. Origin. Exactly. Yeah. And it goes into Krampus, which I kind of like that whole Christmas kind of folklore about Krampus because there's so many different takes on it. So I think that episode really like kind of showed that side of it, like the creepier side and the scarier side because Christmas is so happy. So it's good to have some.
Justin
like,
Bobby is Krampus.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He
yeah.
Is.
Krampus was a little bitch.
Yeah. I do enjoy that aspect. I enjoy the horror aspect of Christmas.
Yeah, I know it's not one. I know we've discussed it. I knew you guys didn't see have never seen it, but if not, even if you don't watch Christmas. Supernatural, if you've never seen it,
the
you
original,
don't have to follow up.
The new
it's,
one.
No.
What?
Connor loves the new Black Christmas movie.
I don't like that movie.
I love Black Christmas.
No, the new one?
I like both. No. I like campy, like crappy.
He's about to kick you off the show.
Shitty horror movies that.
But see, the original Black Christmas is a classic,
good.
Though.
I know.
Like Santa's Sleigh with Goldberg.
Yes, I love Santa's Sleigh.
Great movie. All right, but this is not about Christmas movies.
Okay.
Christmas specials or TV episodes.
All right, so that's my one. Big one.
All right. You guys can fight over who goes next.
Yeah,
I'm going to lay down a knife and then whoever goes.
My favorite Christmas special is the Awesome Sunday Christmas special. All right. Now that I'm done sucking. All right.
You're not done sucking anything.
No, he meant like now that he's done sucking. Like
oh, as in performance wise?
Yeah.
Honestly, I watched it last night, which is pretty funny. That's why it's like fresh in my head. And like, I didn't really have, when you told me about the topic, I didn't really have an idea, to be completely honest with you. But last night, it was probably like 1 a.m, I was bored, and Hey Arnold was on, and it happened to be the Christmas episode. Hey Arnold with me was my favorite cartoon.
It's a great cartoon.
Personally, like, I feel like Hey Arnold is a show that kids should watch growing up, because every episode is pretty much some kind of ethically right reason or moral reasoning behind it. I think you take away something from every episode.
Yeah.
And Hey Arnold as a whole is such a great show, and the nostalgic feeling I got from it with the Helga and like her search for the Nancy Spumoni snow boots.
That's a great episode.
It's where they find Mr. Huynh's daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's an amazing episode.
And what about how Gerald buys everyone a tie?
I bought Timberly a tie. And everything about it's great, because ethically at the end, like, you have Arnold, the voice of reason, doing what's right and trying to help Mr. Huynh. And Mr. Huynh is such an underrated character.
He is. And you know what I really like about that episode too is that the moral lesson usually just revolves around Arnold and his actions. But like, sometimes I remember throughout that show, I haven't watched it recently, that it would branch out to different characters, and you would get how they deal morally with their problems. And you get it with Helga in that episode.
A lot with Helga.
And it's a Christmas episode. So like, it's kind of like, you know, it's almost kind of like a risk that they did that, but I think it really paid off.
Extremely. And it also touched on, like, it really, Hey Arnold really knew, I like how you said that, like, because every episode, I feel like there would be like a Harold episode, a Eugene episode.
Yeah.
Like, there would be various things, and a lot of characters you don't get to see very often, you still have like an emotional connection to. Like Mr. Huynh, you just kind of know him as like the guy that's like the country singer in the one episode.
Yeah.
Like has like one line. But in this one, like, you get a take from like, man, you really gain to feel for Mr. Huynh, because he just comes from like a war-ridden country and just saves his daughter on the helicopter. It's like one of the saddest things I think I've ever seen.
And it's funny. Arnold. It's funny too that like, because like on, at face value, he looks like such a stereotype. But then at the same, but like, he's kind of, you know his past, and like, you know, he's a person, you know. And I really appreciate about that show is that they were able to take like the stereotypical comedy, like comedic factor of them, but make them human as well. They're relatable.
Exactly. And it also had like comedic balance like with it as well. Like, even Mr. Huynh would be telling the story and Arnold would be like, why can't I even get you like a sweater? And he's like, see, I don't need a sweater. Look in my closet. And it just happens to be also, he's like, I've red, green, yellow, blue. And like, just goes and names like every, it's perfect, honestly.
It's great.
It's everything I love.
Oh, it's my turn now?
Philip.
Good pick, Nick. Good pick. I like that one.
Fucking likes you.
I like that one. Okay, I'm sorry. Are you guys like into older Saturday Night Live?
Oh, I put Saturday Night Live on my list
Please
too.
Please tell me you're about to say what I'm thinking.
Are you going
to
say
Sweaty Balls?
We were talking about this.
We were talking about it before.
Okay, so for those that have never seen Sweaty Balls, I'm sorry. It came out in, I believe, the 90s.
Spoilers.
1998.
Anna Gaster, I think her name was. And then it was Molly Shannon and Alec Baldwin. It was NPR. And they brought on the infamous Pete Schwede, who sells all these snacks. And he's trying to plug all of his different stuff. And the highlight of the holiday season was his Schwede balls. And they were malt balls. And there was a lot of puns about balls going in mouths. And it was just one of the most – it might be my favorite skit of all time from SNL. And I think that was like that era, in the late 90s, maybe early 2000s. When SNL was like really last time, like really good, because Adam Sandler was on there too, and like all
that's when Adam Sandler was like actually funny.
Yeah, and but like the whole Sweaty Balls thing, and then he ends up saying like, oh, and for like a one time special, I know we're about to end the show, but we're selling our Sweaty Ball sacks, and you can. it's the most classic skit I have.
It's one
ever
of my favorite
seen.
SNL skits of all time.
It was honestly amazing.
It's seriously so great.
I also had a secondary, which is Festivus from Seinfeld.
The
hands down.
I have a Seinfeld one, but it's, even though Festivus is more in the Christmas spirit, I do have a Christmas special Seinfeld one, but it's not that one. Well, I want to mention my favorite first, but then I'll go back to Seinfeld.
Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead.
You want to? Okay. This is my favorite Christmas special of all time. It's Mickey's Christmas Carol, made by Disney.
I love that one.
It is.
That was very well made.
It's like that is. I try to watch it as much as I can. I used to have it on VHS, but then my brothers threw away all the VHSs one day because he's like, well, why do you need them anymore? And I'm like, damn it.
Because you can go to Costco and get them converted to DVDs.
I know, right? But, I mean, Mickey's Kiss Christmas Carol you can find on Blu-ray. I don't know why I haven't bought it yet. I'm actually kind of disappointed in myself. So, I don't know. Like, to me, that I think that's not only my favorite Christmas special, but I think that's my favorite interpretation of a Christmas Carol in general. How many of you actually seen it?
I love it. I haven't seen it since I was younger, while. But
that's when Donald Duck is Scrooge, right?
Scrooge McDuck is Ebenezer Scrooge.
Ebenezer Scrooge. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Donald Duck is his
is
the nephew.
Yeah. Oh Jesus.
Mickey's Tiny Tim's dad.
Yes.
You also have
Cratchit, Bob Cratchit.
Yeah.
Hey, how about you mute that?
I should.
so unprofessional.
What should we call it? Then you have the Ghost of Christmas Past, played by Jiminy Cricket. Ghost of Christmas Present, Willie the Giant, who was in like some older Disney cartoons. And then the Ghost of Christmas Future, who is Mickey's, Mickey's enemy in the old Disney cartoons, Pete, who's the guy that always like, ha, 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 ha. And Minnie's like, help me.
Wow, that was pretty good.
Thanks. But then, like, the deceased business partner, who, Jacob Marley, is played by Goofy. And it's, like, it's amazing. Because Goofy is low-key,
like, perfect.
One of my favorite Disney characters. If you watch the Goofy cartoons from the 50s, they're not, like, Goofy what you would expect. Like, gosh, Mickey. Like,
wow, that was good, too. Yeah. That was pretty good.
He talked like that, but he was more, like, where Mickey, like, represented, like, innocence, and Donald Duck represented, like, anger in society. Goofy represented, like everyday society. And you see him in the old cartoons, like there's one where he has to quit smoking. There's one where he opens the door and the milkman's expecting a kiss, which is like leading up to adultery. So yeah. Like he's like watching the kids and seeing Goofy in this was like, especially as a kid, was like, you know, awesome. But yeah, just seeing all your favorite Disney characters play out these classic characters. So it's almost like meshing two worlds together. And Disney does that really well. They did it with Kingdom Hearts.
Mm-hmm. And they do it so kids understand it. Because yeah. Christmas Carol is such an old, an older story. So it's nice that they like kind of put it in like a child perspective.
I would like to think Charles Dickens would be proud of this version.
Yeah, because it's still like intellectual. Like adults still enjoy it.
It's adult enough
yeah.
where you understand the themes and the values of the original story, but it's also cute and heartwarming for mm-hmm. kids. And I still think it has the saddest Tiny Tim scene.
Oh my god!
Out of all time,
isn't it? Minnie, it's a little Mickey.
It's Mickey's little son. It's Mickey's and Minnie's little
yeah,
child.
So
and like
cute.
When you watch, like when you show a 5-year-old that like the baby mouse won't make it to Christmas because he's gonna die. Like
he has
what?
A
the
little crutch.
Yeah, he's gonna fucking die. Like holy shit! It's awful.
It is sad.
That's terrible.
Now since we're on the scene.
Phil killed that mouse.
Yeah, I don't know. I love that version of a Christmas. I love that movie. It's literally, if you haven't seen it, it's like 20, I think it's anywhere from 25 to 30 minutes
yeah,
long.
Yeah, it's not long.
Yeah, it's great.
Have you seen the other, there's another Christmas, like a Disney Christmas special, probably not made too far after that.
Is it The Rescuers?
No, it's with Mickey and Minnie and all of them. They have like short little segments, so it's not like a full movie. It's like little short ones, and it's the sweetest one. It's like Mickey and Minnie, and they're like trying to find the perfect gift for each other. So at the end, you know what I'm talking about?
Is it Mickey's Once Upon a Christmas?
Maybe. And they're trying to find the perfect
gift.
The
Magi, right?
Yeah, they're trying to find the perfect gift, and Minnie has a like a necklace, and Mickey has a watch, and they end up selling. Like Mickey sells his watch in order to get Minnie a gift, and Minnie sells her necklace in order to get Mickey a gift. And then when they exchange the gifts, like Mickey got something for Minnie's necklace, and
yeah.
Mickey, you know what I'm talking about?
It's that
about?
Classic story.
Yeah, it's like so cute and so sweet, and it's so nice, like in a like a little kid version. Of
yeah, but that's that. The thing about Disney. Most of the time, Disney like always finds a way to entice the family.
Yeah.
Where it's like, yeah, it's obviously meant for children. It's anthropomorphic animals, like, you know, representing like innocence. But then also, too, you have like some of the dark side of life,
mm-hmm.
you know, but that like kids need to know, but adults can relate to.
Mm-hmm.
And Disney, I think, balances that very well. And like they do it. I've never seen that special, but I'm sure they do it well in that. But in Mickey's Christmas Carol, they do it very well.
Yeah. It's good.
you know, and like you, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, watch The Lion King. Like, that's like the best representation of like a kid's movie, but his dad dies. Like, just fucking like right in front of him.
His
like,
uncle's an asshole. Yeah.
Like, yeah, but that's my favorite Christmas special. Pat, I'd love to hear what you have to say.
All right. You said Seinfeld because you're a bastard, but I guess my favorite would have to be the Community episode, Abed's Uncontrollable Christmas, which I mentioned last year with Dan Spikowski, actually. But I love Community. It's one of my favorite shows of all time. But this episode, you know, it's a comedy, but this episode was, like, kind of very sad, especially at the end. But it's a claymation episode, and it happens because Abed thinks or decides that the group needs to rediscover the meaning of Christmas. And so he imagines the group as different Christmas objects. Like, one is a teddy bear, one's a snowman, one is an elf in the box or Jack in the Box, and so on and so forth. And they have to go on this journey to find the Christmas spirit, all that. And meanwhile, it's all taking place in his head, and the rest of the group is reluctantly going along with it while, like, trying to figure out what mental issue he has. And then there's a lot of humor to it, and then there's also, like, it gets really sad at some parts. And then at the end, you find out it's because he had a breakdown because his mom decided that she didn't want to spend Christmas with him. She wanted to spend it with her new family.
Oh, my goodness.
So, like, he had this breakdown and, like, was doing this to rediscover happiness in his Christmas time. Wow. So it's very sad. Plus, I love claymation. So, like, that added to it. And
who doesn't?
One of my favorite shows.
Yeah, I do love claymation.
Yeah, so that's if I had to pick, that's my favorite. Other than the strike, the Festivus episode.
Can I give an honorable mention?
Yes.
All right. Simpsons episode 1.
Yeah.
I think is a clear honorable mention for any kind of holiday special because it starts out as a Christmas episode.
I do want to talk about the classics a little later on besides like the ones that we specifically like as well. Yeah. I think that falls under a classic too though. It kind of is both. It's on my personal list though too as
kinda.
Well.
It's to me I think The Simpsons is a very significant show in like its own regard.
Yeah.
But
it ended too soon.
Dude, The Simpsons, like, especially
I felt like it could have gone on like another 20 something years.
I know, right?
Can't believe it ended 600 after
episodes?
Season 9.
I'm a huge fan, like, long time, and I haven't really been into it lately, but I mean, like, first 15 seasons, like, I'm in there.
Yeah, I'm a first 10 season guy.
I would go 10 seasons. Yeah. There are here and there between, you know, seasons 11 through 15, there are some, like, really
but
good ones.
I will give them credit. It's a different holiday, but their Treehouse of Horrors are still, like,
still great.
Yeah, all of them
are
good.
I will always watch that every year.
I'll make sure. Even the bad ones are better than most of their newer episodes.
They're always good. They're always good.
Yeah.
The Shining one's amazing.
The Shining. So quiet, boy. You want to get sued?
John Denver. But Simpsons episode 1, where it's so classic, like, in its own regard. Starting out, like, Marge spends all the Christmas money trying to get Bart's, like, tattoo removed. You know?
Yeah.
And then
that's a great one.
Yeah. And then, like, Homer takes up a second job as, like, mall Santa.
Yeah.
And then, like, blows all the money on, like, dog racing and, like, all this different stuff.
But then they find money. Santa's little helper.
Exactly. But it comes out positive, and they find Santa's little helper, who's the dog, the family dog throughout the entire show.
And that's the present to the family. Like, it just grows to show you that gifts are just more than material things. Like,
exactly.
I got a dog for Christmas. That's how I got my dog.
Yeah?
That was our Christmas gift, even though we got her the day after New Year's, but it was a Christmas gift still, technically.
Oh, what a good gift.
Did you know you were getting a dog on Christmas?
Well, not until we opened things that were dog-related, yeah.
Okay. It's a nice story. Mm-hmm. But no, yeah, what else were you saying about the episode?
Kind of in general, like, it really sets a tone just kind of for the series, and it's crazy that, like, a show like that has been on for so long started off with, like, a Christmas special, you know?
Yeah.
Like, the pilot episode, like, hey, like, we're just gonna wing it and go for Christmas. Like, I think that's kind of bold. I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's, like, a way, because I feel like when people are gonna watch something, like, they're gonna stick with, like, I don't know, like Charlie Brown, like classic things like that.
Right.
Just gonna like be like, oh, let me check out this random pilot episode.
That's technically the first episode aired, but it was actually the 8th episode produced.
And okay, yeah, because there's ones previous to that.
Yeah, right? It's like it's technically season 1, episode 1, that episode, but it wasn't intended to be. I don't know why. I don't know the story why they aired it first.
I'm not too positive.
Yeah. But it was a it's a great way to start off a show, because I do consider that a classic Christmas special. Mm-hmm. I don't know how well received it was at the time.
Yeah, I feel like Simpsons is like a show that had to like kind of grow on people. Yeah. At least it kind of grew on me, because
yeah,
I started watching it, I don't know, maybe I was like 8 or 9 years old, and it took a while for me to get into it. But then again, when I was watching it, I don't know, it was like...
Well, Simpsons jokes are very fast, because they only have 22 minutes to have a joke, but then you have like adult situations, so like the jokes are quick in that show. So as a kid... You know, usually like when you watch shows like you know, we grew up with like the Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy, where like there was maybe like 4 or 5 solid jokes, but they were kind of just like building up to something like humorous, because exactly. You know, they want the kids to get all the joke, and also there's a story to tell. Whereas The Simpsons was like genius, because they were able to blend a story but also incorporate the jokes like within the conversation at all time. And shows follow
while
that.
While doing a parody.
Too. While doing a parody. And show it even shows whether they were more adult or less adult and still for kids were following that. And The Simpsons set that standard. And, mm-hmm. you know, I'm a fan of The Simpsons too. Like, I'm right there with you, man. And, I can do a Simpsons podcast, and, like, we should do that one day.
I'm 100%
in. Yeah. But no, very, very good mention, man. That's on my list, and I'm glad you brought it up. Great, great episode. Anybody else have anything else they want to bring up as far as Christmas specials?
I guess that 70s show, they seem to always have one for all their seasons. I think they have 8 seasons, 7, 8. I think it's 8.
8.
And 8, I don't really consider the last season a season. It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad. Nobody's in it. Eric's
Randy
not in it.
Sucks.
Kelso's Randy not in it.
Sucks.
He does suck. He looks like Eric, but a not cool Eric.
It sucks because it's Seth Meyers' brother, and I like Seth Meyers. Josh
Is it
Myers.
Really?
Yeah.
Doesn't mean you have to like his brother.
I didn't know that was his brother.
His little bitch, yeah. Like Randy.
That's I hate Randy.
He's just
wild.
Such a like. You had characters that were like that looked like looked like the stereotypical like 70s group.
Yeah, so 70s.
But they had such unique personalities each, but like. And then you just get like Randy, like
who's he was
just,
such an outcast.
Yeah, he just like was like, I'm a stereotypical like 1970s kid. I'm gonna act like it too.
Yeah,
I'm an unfunny Kelso.
He was not funny. He was like a combination of Eric and Kelso, and it was terrible. But like not a good combination.
Yeah.
Like not a good version.
He was just like bad glue. Like they tried to like
fill
a void
a good
with
way
like glue,
it.
But then like you pick at it for like a little bit, and then after like I don't know 5 minutes, you peel it off, and you're like, this sucks again.
Yeah,
the void's still there.
That's pretty much it. The one that sticks, I mean, I wrote down pretty much all of that, but I think probably one from all the seasons, but there was one scene that, like, it cracks me up every time I watch it, where they, I guess, Red and Kitty give them, like, $40 to get a Christmas tree, and instead they want to save the $40 for, like, beer or whatever, and they go into the woods and they cut down a tree, so they're trying to, like, dodge the cars from seeing them. And they cut down this tree and they bring it home, and Kitty comes out and she's like, wow, this tree, it's great. And then like all these birds start flying out of it, and it's just like this crazy scene.
Don't the cops show up, right?
Yeah, all these crazy things happen, of course. But I mean, that's just really every Christmas special that they do or Christmas episode that they do, I really think it's pretty funny.
Like how I said this before, but the show took place over what, like 3 or 4 years?
Yeah, and it's like 8 years, really.
And yeah, and they had like 8 Christmas episodes, 10 Halloween ones.
Yeah.
They had like 2 Thanksgiving ones in one season, I think, at one point or something.
Yeah.
They had 2 of one holiday in the same season.
You know, Nick's favorite show is that 80s show.
I mean, who isn't?
The Rock was on it.
The Rock was on that?
I'm glad you brought that up, because one of my other favorite Christmas episodes, someone was in that, Glenn Howerton, who plays Dennis on Always Sunny in Philadelphia, one of my favorite shows.
Yes.
And their episode, Very Sunny Christmas, I think, is one of my favorite Christmas episodes, and one of my favorite episodes of that show ever, anyway. But it starts off like Dennis and Dee are hating Christmas because Frank is the worst gift giver ever, and Charlie and Mac are like, no, and they're like, no, he buys stuff he knows we want just to like mess with us. Like Frank gets a certain Lamborghini that Dennis wants and drives it around, and then he gets this like name bag purse, like designer handbag that Dee wants, and it's Frank, like Danny DeVito, and he needs a designer handbag. So then they try to mess with Frank, and they try to go the whole, you know, Ghost of Christmas Past route. And that backfires because they want his old business partner, who he screwed out of millions of dollars, to, like, fuck with him. But the guy's, like, a born-again Christian. He goes, I forgive you, blah, blah, blah. So then, like, they go and they hide. They want to see what Frank's former colleagues they give him. So they sew him into a couch, a leather couch, at a Christmas party. And he gets – he's waiting for it to happen. And they're trying to, like, goad people into saying this stuff. And at one point, he gets so hot that he crawls out of the couch naked. Like, he's crawling. It looks – like, they made it look like the couch was giving birth to him in the middle of this huge Christmas party. And it was hysterical. But the absolute best part of this episode – or best, like, scenes were Mac describing his family's Christmas traditions, which was they would go to somebody's house and open those gifts that were there, and they got to keep whatever ones they liked. And then Charlie, who is, like, a dumbass, had to be like, yeah, no, you're breaking into people's houses and stealing their gifts. Then they try to get that robot toy that was, like, from the classic 80s. I forget exactly what it was called, but... And then Charlie thinks back to about his mother's encounter with Santa. Mac realizes, informs Charlie, he's like, yeah, no, your mom was whoring herself out so she could get money for your Christmas presents. And it was just guys who came over as Santa. So then they, so when they go to the mall to look for this that robot toy, Charlie sits down on Santa's lap and he goes, did you fuck my mom? Did you fuck my... And he gets louder and louder and more crazy, and then he fucking bites Santa right in the neck and rips some skin off. It was so funny. And then at the end, Frank pranks him. There's, like, a little claymation part, and then at the end, like, this whole big thing happens. And, I mean, the ending was, like, great, but, like, the whole thing with Charlie and Max, like, discoveries were fantastic. That's one of my favorite episodes. There's
Charlie and Mac shenanigans, like, and it's so
they're always fun. So good. They're,
every single episode, like, I'm like, it can't get better, and, like, they find a way to, like, at least once or twice every season, it's like, mm-hmm. Man, they really did something good here.
It's so good.
That's so funny.
Phil, you look like you want to say something.
No, I don't know if you guys are. It's really old. The Honeymooners. It only ran for 2 seasons.
Yeah,
it's one of my favorite shows.
It's a great show.
It's one of my favorite shows of all time.
It's one of the first sitcoms, or if not the first, I want to say.
They followed, like, with their Christmas special they did, they followed the same thing as the Gift of the Magi. Like, he wanted to buy her a gift, but then his thing was it's not going to live up to the expectations. So he ended up selling his bowling ball. But there's, like, so many funny fucking parts in that that show, or that Christmas special, that, like, he just, like, completely just flips out over the whole damn thing.
That's the one where he goes, one of these days, I'm right to the moon.
Right to the moon, Alice. Yeah, that's on every New Year's Day. They run a marathon.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
And Eddie Murphy probably has one of the best stand-up material of all time, making fun of the Honeymooners. If you've ever seen Eddie Murphy Delirious, he makes fun of the Honeymooners.
I haven't seen that stand-up. Hoffman loves that special.
Yeah, he would.
It's great.
Hoffman has a terrible Chris Rock impression, though.
I thought it was good.
I'm sorry.
All right. Well, that's why Hoffman's not here. No, I'm just kidding. I want Hoffman back on the show. It's been a while since he's been here.
It's been a while
since I first saw Matt. Okay. I want to go back to Seinfeld, though.
Okay.
This is
the strike is great too.
Yeah, that's a great one. But I think, in my opinion, the funniest. Even though Festivus is great, it's a classic.
Yeah.
The red dot to me is is just like. I can't get over. And at the end, we're like, Cashmere. And George is like, yeah, Cashmere. Like, it's just banging her. Like, dude, that cracks me up. I can't help but laugh whenever I think of that episode. It's so goddamn good. It's so fucking funny. That episode is great.
I'm about to have one of your laughs.
When I saw Louis C.K. the other week, there was like 5 guys that had that Connor laugh, all sitting around me. I had to keep looking for this, you know, big goon, like.
Dude, it's like a seal. Like Louis C.K. has that one bit where he's like, "You ever see like a seal in real life?" And instead of going "ar ar," it just goes And his daughter's like, what is he saying?
I'm a slave.
Jesus.
All right. Sarah, any more? Pat, any more that you would like to bring up?
How I Met Your Mother. There's a good one on there. Lily Stole Christmas.
Yeah. Yes, I like that was one. On my list. That's a great one, when she's a Grinch.
Yeah, she really is. And they use the word Grinch to describe. Instead of, but I guess you just... up for imagination what the actual word is, but
oh, it's cunt.
Oh, it is. I thought it was too.
Yeah, he called her a bad
I wasn't
word.
Sure if it was bitch or the other one.
No,
I can't
because
say the C word.
Say,
but
they
I...
say bitch on the show.
Oh, I guess you're right.
So the one that they didn't say, which they would have to bleep out,
would be
was
that one.
That.
Okay, and what all the
gonna,
kids?
He's not going to tell his kids that he called their aunt.
I like when he's at his cousin's, the really religious family.
Oh yeah, on Staten Island.
Yes, and the kid is like, "Mom, what does Grinch mean?" But it's really the C word. It's so funny.
So great. That was a really good episode.
Yeah, I like that episode. It's good.
It doesn't hold up to their Thanksgiving episode, Slapsgiving.
Yes, Slapsgiving is good.
1, 2, and 3,
but
one of the greatest sequences of episodes in television history.
Yes. But I do like how Lily Stole Christmas.
Yeah, when Barney is like so sick and wants to go laser tagging, but he still what happened? He gets like sick, and how he always says legendary. Mm-hmm. He like said it, but then he always finishes it when he said it. So he like started to say it, and then he like fell asleep, and then towards the end of the scene, he like wakes up out of nowhere and finishes it, which is like I think is really funny.
Another How I Met Your Mother episode though, that was Christmas. I think it was later on. It was false positive, even though it was centered around Christmas time.
Yes,
but that was a very dramatic episode.
That was a very good episode, actually. It's one of their best episodes of the later seasons,
right?
Especially because at the end, like man, that was very sad. It was very sad. V sad.
Marshall and Lily, I tell everybody like they're pregnant. This is awesome. Like that's sweet. Like for that to happen for the show and everything. And then at the end of the episode, they found out it was a false positive. So, like, everything, like, centered around Christmas joy and everything throughout the whole thing, and then it's just one giant letdown. So.
And the one with Robin, when she thinks for a while she's pregnant, and then turns out she's barren.
Yeah.
Was also Christmas time. And then at the end.
Was that a Christmas episode? That wasn't Little Minnesota, right? That was another Christmas one.
It was another Christmas one, and then at the end, you know, she won't tell anybody, and Ted, you know, does this huge, like, big thing set to AC/DC. In their apartment. Mm-hmm. That was a really good episode. At first I thought you were going to say that episode, but that one was also very sad.
Yeah. I'll tell you, that's one show that really nailed like the holiday episodes, like especially with Slutty Pumpkin, and then you find out like it's like 3 years later it's Katie Holmes, she's annoying as hell.
Although I will give her credit because that made me try Kraken and Root Beer.
Okay, yeah. Oh, dude.
That is good.
Nice.
I don't watch How I Met Your Mother, but I've had Kraken and Root Beer, and it's good.
Mm-hmm.
You got to do it with Stewart's, though.
I recommend a drink, yeah. I recommend the show.
Yeah, I recommend the show,
except for
I
the last season.
I binge-watched it one summer.
The last season could go fuck itself, especially that finale. It's such a slap in the face to everybody. Just saying.
You just got slapped.
And now we're about to get a spinoff. Again, they already tempted one and fucking blew. Do you have another one, Harry?
I mean, just some classics. I think, like, you know, the Simpsons roasting over an open fire, the one we mentioned before, was really good, classic one. I think you can't mention Christmas specials without thinking of really, like, the two essentials, and I think in the future, the three essentials. But this is my prediction, like, 10 or 20 years from now. One, How the Grinch Stole Christmas, and then Charlie Brown Christmas Special, that one. You can't not... I've watched those every year. I love them. But I think Woodland Christmas... Woodland Critter Christmas from South Park, that, I think, in the future, will be one of like the classic Christmas comedy specials.
I haven't seen it.
I don't think for everyone, but...
But, like, it's not... Obviously, it won't reach the same level of magnitude or, like... or widespread acclaim that like How the Grinch Stole Christmas or Charlie Brown will ever will, but I don't know, Woodland Critter Christmas, like when I first saw that when it aired.
I think it's a little too outrageous for most people. It is a fan. I love that episode.
Yeah, but
I did go with the different South Park.
But here's the thing though, like we grew up with South Park.
So I think like when my like I think that's something that like when my kids are old enough, like when they're like 14, 15, 16, I'm like, all
you're
right.
You're gonna show it to them when they first learn how to talk.
Yeah. I'm like, all right, this is something like I used to show you this as a kid, like Charlie Brown and the Grinch, you know, and like Mickey's Christmas Carol. Like, now you're old enough. Don't tell your
Forget
mother.
All that shit. Yeah. This is way better.
Don't tell your mother, but I'm gonna put this on for you. Like that's like Woodland Christmas Critter to me. Mm-hmm. Or Woodland Critters Christmas.
Yeah, Mr. Hanky.
That's so the one I picked. Yeah, Mr. Hanky, Christmas
Poo. Mr. Hanky, the Christmas Poo is like, yeah. Like a classic. One that came to mind for me is like I was a big Nickelodeon kid.
Oh, I love Nickelodeon.
Rugrats, I thought, had an excellent Christmas. Do you remember the Rugrats Christmas?
See, I like their Hanukkah episodes better.
They have a Hanukkah and a Kwanzaa episode. Yeah. Do you remember that with Susie's family?
Yep.
Yeah, they really touch
yeah,
on
Yeah, I think the Hanukkah one is the best one, though.
Yeah, I like the Hanukkah ones a lot, too.
They have the... Rugrats... what was it? Rugrats Hanukkah, I think it's called. Something like that.
I think it's called that. And what I really liked about the Hanukkah specials...
Boris and Minka.
Or the one special in general...
Old country.
back in the old country.
When Tommy goes to the temple and they go through Moses' story, Exodus. And like there's...
It's a good history lesson.
Yeah, the Rugrats like was a great show growing up because like every episode was about adventure. And like they lost that with All Grown Up. I hate that show.
Oh, that was terrible.
Your friend.
No, I hate that show. But Rugrats always gave you like... It was like... great children's programming should always give kids a sense of adventure because it makes them want to branch out and seek the world and study more. And I think it really having a sense of adventure, like just I think generally is just an intelligent thing to grasp, mm-hmm. like especially as a kid, because you learn more. And I really liked that in the Hanukkah episode because you saw the adventure of Moses, how he led the Jews out of Egypt. And they didn't hide back, you know, like they were slaves. And you saw Pharaoh, but I loved how, like, just like Mickey's Christmas Carol, you see all these famous characters play other famous characters. You have the Rugrats characters playing stories from the Bible and playing characters from stories of the Bible and Exodus. And was Angelica the Pharaoh? I want to say she was.
Probably.
Yeah, she would fit most that
obvious
role.
Choice.
Yeah.
Well, not. It's also great because how many Hanukkah specials can you name?
Not really a lot at all.
Exactly. Like even Seinfeld, and with the main character, Jerry Seinfeld, being Jewish, no Hanukkah.
Yeah.
Hey Arnold doesn't have a Hanukkah episode, but they have the one of Harold's bar mitzvah.
Yeah.
I mean, that kind of touches like a little bit, I guess.
Yeah, but even still, so like that's why, aside from that just being a great episode of the Rugrats, it's I think also a very like great for that too.
You guys, since we're talking about Nickelodeon, you know who has a Christmas special?
Oh, don't say it.
Drake and Josh. Parents, live action.
Drake and Josh does.
Drake and Josh does. It's actually really sweet.
Listen, Drake and Josh was a pretty good show at the time.
Yeah.
I like Drake and Josh a lot.
And it's actually super sweet. They have, of course, they have like a party or something, and it's a party gone wrong. So if they don't save this foster family for Christmas, they have to go to jail for this whole party that went on. So it is a really sweet story. It's more of like a movie, like one of their like mini TVs.
Is that when they used like the wood chippers to try and make snow?
Yes.
And all the ice went through the person's window?
Yes. It's so good because Drake sings. And
a little
it's great.
Backstory. Drake Bell is Sarah's greatest obsession.
I love him so much.
Which do you love more? Horror movies and Halloween or a Drake Bell?
Ooh, that's a close call, but I mean, horror movies have been like my birth, since the womb. Drake Bell's been since second grade, third grade, so not too far off. I don't know. That's a hard one.
I've always been more of a...
It was a horror movie starring Drake Bell. That's your perfect...
He does have one. It was like straight to DVD.
Oh, God.
Straight to DVD one.
I've been more of a Josh Peck fan, not because of Drake...
Love Josh Peck.
Not because of Drake and Josh, because of Mean Creek.
Oh, Mean Creek when he's like... he's like, listen up! What does he say? I actually have it.
I don't want to say it.
You love them because of Red Dawn.
No, I've never seen that. I don't like the original Red Dawn either.
Wait, if I play a video on here, does it pick up sound?
The original Red Dawn sucks.
It won't be
and
good.
And the remake of Red Dawn sucks.
Let's not put it on because he says some really
bad stuff. Oh, yeah, he
does
say some bad things.
He says some terrible shit. But,
Red Dawn sucks. Awesome Sunday show. Do not support.
No, we don't. We don't. But we understand where this anger lies from.
He's a piece of shit.
Yeah, he is. Okay, so back to Christmas specials. I guess just to ask you guys a question, unless you have any more specials you want to bring up.
I have actually a bunch.
Yeah, then.
As usual.
Yeah.
All right. One I was actually kind of expecting Sarah to say, from Parks and Recreation.
Oh, I almost did.
Oh, you did?
It Citizen was on Note. My list.
Citizen we, Note?
Yes, yes.
Great episode.
Yeah. I love that is Parks a good and Rec. One. There's a few on Parks and Rec.
There
and
is, but
ones.
That,
that's a
like,
good
that
one, though.
One's like,
that's I the best one. Because there's another one that it's called, what did I say? I actually don't remember what it was called, but it was like in season 2. Mm-hmm. So it was like when the cast wasn't as great.
Yeah.
As like this the one middle is like, of it.
It's about, you know, Leslie's campaign starting to fall mm-hmm. apart, and then her and Ben's relationship is causing problems, and then Ben goes seek private sector jobs, and then the department is trying to get Leslie a gift, and it's just it's a great, I mean, that show is fantastic, but it's a great episode.
Does Mr. Pickles have a Christmas episode?
No,
not yet,
but they need one.
Going back to animation, you and I have, from the same show but different episodes, I put for Futurama, Xmas Story, which is when we're introduced to the killer robot Santa.
Yeah, and I think the second one's better. What's the second one called again?
To be honest, I don't remember.
I think it's Red Sleigh Down. Or, no, that's South Park still. I think the second one's better.
Well,
yeah,
maybe, but like this one, I think is more memorable because you're introduced.
It is the first one.
It is this killer robot Santa that was created to judge who's naughty and nice, except his judgment settings were set to ridiculous things. So he pretty much considers everybody naughty, and he tries to kill you if you're out on Christmas Eve
by midnight.
It's
Krampus.
Yeah, except not as except demonic.
Okay.
Just more like
comedic.
Well, that I mean, like psychopath, yeah. Like pure psychopath.
That's so funny.
What one did you put on your list, Connor? Futurama.
It's not the second one. I take that back. It's actually the third one. The Futurama Holiday Spectacular. It's the one where they do all the little like episodes mm-hmm. into one episode. The only problem I have with this, I've actually when I was looking up the episode, some of the like critics agreed with this too, is that like Robot Santa comes to sing with them in mm-hmm. the beginning. It was kind of weird. But then the rest of the episode is great.
Well, I mean, the show itself is like out there, so I'm not surprised.
It was just weird. This is such an evil character.
Yeah, it never bothered me.
But yeah, I have to say that. It's actually the third episode.
Family Guy, a very special Family Guy freaking Christmas.
Is that the first Christmas special where Lois goes crazy?
Season 3. Yeah. It's
that one's great.
A great episode. One of my favorite Family Guy episodes. But Lois signs up Stewie to be baby Jesus in the nativity scene. And he goes because he wants to please Santa because he wants to get plutonium. And he thinks like Santa can do anything. He's like omnipotent. Lois wants Peter to donate a present to charity, and instead, he gives away all the family's Christmas gifts. And Lois is fine, and then she's like, no, we got to go to the mall. And all Peter wants to do is watch Kiss Save Santa. That's all he wants to do is watch.
That's the best running joke. And Kiss Save Santa. The whole Kiss Save Santa segments are better than the episode. And the episode is fucking funny, but like when they cut to Kiss Save Santa, it is like, that's when Family Guy was like, at its best for me, like that, like those, like from seasons, like even like after like revived, like those well, couple
yeah,
seasons afterwards
were
great.
This is pre-cancellation.
Yeah, that's why. Pre-cancellation Family Guy, like season 2, is like some of the funniest shit. Like that, like Kiss Save Santa, like that's such an out there idea.
It's so yeah, it's just like back when they were like completely ridiculous without being like current episodes.
Yeah, but
which suck.
But it's also kind of like a cool parody too, because like there was like. You always hear of like weird mashups, like you know, like Scooby Doo used to do that, like when they were like with the Harlem Globetrotters.
Do that.
Yeah,
they did that. I think they did have. They have a
kiss
one.
Yeah, Batman and Robin.
They have a kiss one. Scooby Doo.
Do they do?
Yeah, it's like a newer one.
And the, like Scooby Doo's always like kind of done that, even with like whether it's like Christmas or not Christmas episodes.
The Hex Girls.
Remember What's New Scooby Doo when they did like when they would do like 2000 early 2000s pop punk songs.
Yeah.
Like on the show.
Oh yeah. Have you seen the? Well, not to change the subject. Never mind.
No.
The, like anime kind of Scooby Doo.
No.
It's
I did see your
Mystery
Snapchat.
Mystery Inc. I don't. It's the newest one. Oh my god, it's actually wild. It's pretty good though. I watched it with my cousins. It's still good, but it's very a weird take on it.
Yeah.
They have a Krampus episode too.
So it is relevant.
Yeah, it's pretty
there
relevant.
There we go.
All right. I'm going to go back to this one. Bob's Burgers, Christmas in the
oh,
Car.
Oh, I love Bob's Burgers.
Every episode that show has ever done is fantastic. I don't even give a shit what anybody could just. But this one, it like most of it takes place in them in a car getting chased down by this giant candy cane truck. Because they think they pissed them off somehow. After they go to get their third Christmas tree in like as many days. And just the entire thing, everything that happens through, all the jokes are just fantastic. Just great, great episode.
What season is that? Do you know?
I want to go home and watch it.
I don't know if I've seen that episode.
Season 5.
I don't think I saw it.
On your list, is any of like the Office like Christmas party episodes? Like
The first Office Christmas party.
Is that the iPod one?
Yes. What if there? Oh, I love that. First of all, Office is a fantastic show.
Amazing.
But yes, that Office Christmas, I mean, they had good ones after that, but nothing lived up to that one.
Michael exceeds, like, it's like a $20 limit,
right?
Yeah, it
was like a $20 limit, and then he wants to impress Ryan, the temp, because he was obsessed with him. So he buys him a brand new iPod, and, like, this was back when, like, iPods were starting to, like, getting introduced. Yeah, it was a few hundred dollars. And then, like, when he realizes, like,
he makes the rule.
Yeah, he all of a sudden, like, turns it into a Yankee swap until he can either get the iPod back or get it to Ryan. And, like, throughout the thing, like, everybody's, like, really not happy about it because they all did Secret Santa. So they put their effort into pleasing whoever they got.
Because Phyllis got him, like, this, like, handmade like, present.
Yeah, and he hated it. He goes, why put in this, you know, $400 iPod? And I'm getting this. And, like, funny. And then in the background, you know, Jim's very upset because he had this, like, really thoughtful gift for Pam with all these inside jokes. Mm-hmm. And then it kept getting taken. And he had to trade away, you know, whatever.
Wasn't it supposed to go to Dwight or something like that?
I think at one point, Dwight or Creed got it. And he, like, traded them something ridiculous.
Creed. Underrated character.
Dude, amazing.
Creed. Oh, was this the one where Dwight was selling the dolls, too? Was that this one? That was the one with when they send Meredith to rehab, I think.
Yeah.
It was a later one, but that was great, too.
It's not that one. I know
it's not that one. But, that was great, too. But, yeah, The Office Christmas Party episode was fucking great.
I believe it was
great.
Season 2,
yes.
I want to say season 2.
So good. BoJack Horseman Christmas special. I thought it was a nice little special. BoJack Horseman, huge fan of that show. Definitely recommend it.
You
mean BoJack Heston?
That's right.
Don't insult BoJack like that. Come on, man. Black Mirror, White Christmas. I don't know if anybody here has watched Black Mirror.
Oh, I love Black Mirror, but I've never seen that one.
I watched the first episode yesterday.
Of season one.
And like
the first.
It blows your mind.
Okay, the guy like bangs a pig, like literally, like just
on camera, live TV.
Like, dude, he you don't see it, but
you know, you hear the squeals.
Yeah.
Jesus.
But the Black Mirror White Christmas. If you haven't seen Black Mirror, it's like very mostly centered
very
about
twisted.
Technology and like twists on that, and like also with social commentary.
Twilight Zone with technology.
Yeah, good way to put it. And this has 4 parts, and it actually stars John Hamm in it, too, which I thought was great. It's an intro, and it's like John Hamm, this other guy, work at this remote outpost in the middle of some snowy wilderness, and don't know what it is. But in the background, you just hear, I wish it could be Christmas every day, playing on the radio the entire time. And neither of them really remember how long they've been working there or when they first met or anything. They just knew like their time was coming up. So then we go into backgrounds of, like, how they got there, and they tell these stories. And, like, John Hamm was pretty much, like, the hitch of this new technology-based area. And then in the second one, like, it's really – I mean, I don't want to go too much into it because it actually is pretty long. It's, like, almost 90 minutes or something. Mm-hmm. But at the end, the ending was, like – like most Black Mirror episodes, like really good, like mind fuck, like at the end, like a nice good
twist.
Yeah,
I like how that show does that.
But very good, definitely recommend. John Hamm kills it in it because it's fucking John Hamm. I mean, come on,
he's the man.
He's an awesome actor.
He's awesome in Wet Hot American Summer.
Yes, I love that show.
First day camp.
And the last one I want to mention is a Scrubs episode, my own personal Jesus.
Dude, I think I've seen every episode of Scrubs, and I'm trying to remember that one.
Yeah, I don't remember
it's
that
It's actually
one.
A very, very depressing episode.
A lot of Scrubs episodes are.
Yeah, and it like I don't think most people realize that when they start watching it. They're like, oh, this is like a really funny show. But Scrubs balanced comedy and drama very, very well.
Yeah.
But this one, like, it starts off, JD's about to say to this family, like, the patient who has been in a coma is like, he's done. Like, you can't really do anything. He wakes up. Turk's like, oh, it's a Christmas miracle. Turk is a very big Christian. You know, he's very into his faith. And, he believes, like, it's made it who he is. And then he has the worst night on Christmas Eve, like, ever in the ER. A couple patients die. All these personal things. He starts losing, like, questioning his faith. And that's, like, a really big part in it. And then... Elliot's in the free clinic and she comes across like some sad stuff with this pregnant girl. Meredith has this serious syndrome, and then just throughout the episode, as most Scrubs episodes happen, each of the main characters is like suffering from something or going through something really sad. But I think Turk's arc in it was the best part, even though it's a Christmas episode, is like probably one of the most depressing Christmas episodes I've ever seen. But still very good.
That is a good one. I have to rewatch that because I don't really remember that episode that well.
Mm-hmm.
And like, that one should stick out. What season is it? Is it season 1, 2, 3?
It's season 1, episode 11.
Okay. Yeah. All right, I have to rewatch that. But yeah, is that
any other episodes?
Anybody else got any? Because, all right.
You know what Phil likes though?
What?
The Star Wars Holiday Special.
Oh, I was gonna make that joke about Nick, but okay, yeah. Phil's wearing the Star Wars shirt.
How could you, Phil?
It all started with a Heinz ketchup bottle.
Has anybody ever seen the Star Wars Holiday Special? Because I actually have seen it.
Is that like a cartoon?
I have not.
It's semi a cartoon.
Well, yeah.
Stir whip.
It is horrible.
It's shitty.
Really?
Oh, it is like...
Why do you think I'm so pissed right now?
I don't know. You love it.
It's shitty. Like, okay, really bad.
Okay, what? Would you rather watch that or episode 1 or 2?
I'd rather watch episode 1 or 2.
Episode 1 or 2.
Yeah.
I've never seen it, so I think I'll give it a try.
Oh, dude, it's horrible. All right, it's like really, really horrible.
Watch the holiday special, but then watch the Nostalgia Critic review of the Star Wars Holiday Special. It's one of the funniest like internet videos I've ever seen.
I've never seen that. Oh my gosh,
it is incredible. He just like he goes high on the Nostalgia Critic, like if you don't remember, and he just like runs out the door, and like the Star Wars Holiday Special is like chasing him. Like it's just it's just starts off great. It's a but the film itself is hilariously bad. Like, the fact that, like, there's a holiday in the Star Wars universe around, like, the Wookiees. And, like, and Chewbacca's my favorite Star Wars character. And, like, it's like, why the Wookiees? But I will grant it this, though. It did make the Star Wars universe seem bigger and more expansive in a way you would never think.
Interesting. Yeah. I guess I'll have to check it out. Yeah.
Let's bring
You're not missing anything.
No, you're not. But it's funny. But is there any like classic ones that you guys want to talk about? The traditional. Like, how do you guys feel about How the Grinch Stole Christmas? Like, does it strike a chord with you? Do you still think it's relevant today?
I do love How the Grinch Stole Christmas. It's funny. Cindy Lou Who, she's actually in this crazy intense band called The Pretty Reckless. So the girl who played Cindy Lou Who, if you see her now, you'll be so surprised.
Oh, you're talking about the live action movie.
Yeah, you're talking about the cartoon.
I'm talking about the cartoon. The Chuck
Jones
one.
That one's still good too. Yeah,
you're
they're
right.
Both good.
That girl has gotten like really weird.
Yeah, so. Taylor Momsen.
Can I see a picture of her?
Is she hot?
I've seen her in concert. She's pretty amazing.
Sorry, there's just this big spider crawling on my.
Oh.
Oh really?
Oh, yeah. That's fucking horrifying.
But I heard she's like not a nice person, so that stinks.
So he throws it on the floor.
I hope it bites all your feet.
It's all right. I'm wearing socks. Yeah, I think the Chuck Jones original cartoon is just like perfect. And I like the Ron Howard live action with Jim Carrey. I think it pales in comparison to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
But even Ron Howard himself said like you can't recapture
that Yeah, magic. I think it's like totally, I consider them two different ones. Like, I just find that I connect more with the live action one.
I gotta give it to Jim Carrey,
than,
though. He fucking killed it as the Grinch. He is like, he is the live action Grinch. Yeah. Like, you know, for the flaws that movie may have.
Baby Grinch is so cute, though.
Yeah, but you like Mike Myers as Cat in the Hat better.
No.
You like
that movie better. That movie sucks.
Hey, that's my favorite movie, man.
Coming from Nick. No, but yeah, you know. When how do you guys feel about How the Grinch Stole Christmas? Because that's just like, that is like...
Cartoon?
Yeah.
It's classic, man. I love that. I could watch it over and over again.
Cartoon, I think, is a classic. I'm not too big on the live action one, per se.
Really?
To be honest with you, like, I never really was big on it as a kid.
I can see why, though, his perspective.
I
without even saying anything. Because you probably see the same flaws that I see, but I think the positive outweigh the negatives.
I just think they try to do too much, and I don't know. It just wasn't the same. I mean, it's not supposed to be the same, but do you get, like, you have, like, a connection. Like, I grew up with the old Grinch, and, like, I remember, like, that movie came out. I remember when it came out, and I didn't know how I felt about that, and I was, like, 9 years old. And if I could figure it out then, I'm sure I have problems with it now.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
I see what you're saying.
It wasn't for me.
You want to know what Marvel's first... like film crossover was
Batman versus Superman.
No, it was actually it was actually the Grinch and the Cat in the Hat.
Wait, but
I've seen that.
Yeah, I believe
I've seen that.
I want to say that's a Marvel. I think that's a Marvel production. I'm gonna look it up real fast. But yeah, How the Grinch Stole Christmas is a classic. As I'm looking this up because I'm on air. I don't want to be wrong.
While you're looking that up, another classic is I think we did mention before, but Charlie Brown.
Yeah.
Charlie Brown Christmas to me is like the classic Christmas cartoon.
That doesn't do it for me.
I have to watch it like every year. Like I have to. My dad and I watch it every year. It's just kind of always been a tradition. I don't know what it is, but I just keep coming back. Like I
just keep coming back every year.
I think ABC like has a
there's certain thing. There's certain things you have to watch every year. One of them is the Charlie Brown. The other one is, well, for me, it's a Wonderful Life. You have to watch at least Christmas Story at least three times on Christmas Day, and you have to watch
Jack Frost.
Oh yes. My God! That movie made me cry.
Wait a second. Okay, first off, the special is called "The Grinch Grinches the Cat in the Hat," and yes, it is a Marvel production. Second,
I love Jack Frost.
I don't know if you're talking about the Jack Frost that we're talking about. Are you talking about the Michael Keaton one?
Yeah.
Oh God. No.
All right, I'm talking about the slasher horror.
Yes, I love that one too.
With
the killer snowman.
Yeah, and he kills the one girl by humping her.
Terrible kills in the world, so good.
There's like a running joke that falls flat throughout that entire Christmas special. It's like, what's the difference between a snowman and a snowwoman? Snowballs. And they say it like two or three times in the movie. And it's like, Jesus. It's not funny, but it's so not funny.
Dude,
that
that's
it's funny.
That's a joke you would make.
That movie is one of those ones I like would it. See. I used to see that movie at Block or Hollywood Video. I'd go in with my dad, and that was like that movie. I was like, I want to watch this movie. I would always ask my dad, and he was like, why do you want to watch this movie?
It was
movie?
Always at Hollywood Video and Blockbuster. It was there too.
Yeah, it was just like the cover was like so enticing, and then I finally watched it, and I was like, I was probably eight when I first watched it, and I was like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah. But both Jack Frosts are bad, but like in their own way.
No, the one Jack Frost, I cried.
I was referring to the Michael Keaton Jack
Frost. Yeah, he definitely didn't see the other one.
I didn't see
where he like slides off the road.
It's so sad. I cried.
That was a low point in Michael Keaton's career.
That and Mighty Joe Young or whatever that one was cried so hard.
Yeah.
Sad ones.
Yeah, I guess. I mean,
he's a snowman. He died, and he can't be with his son.
I thought that movie was
He's a man that was a snowman, and he gets into wild and wacky adventures with his children. Like a snowball fight. Yeah.
But
she's in Rob Schneider.
He's done once the snow melts.
There's boob jokes.
Who's the better guitarist in that movie? Jack Frost or Anthony Dentino?
Jack fucking Frost. Dentino is Jack Frost.
New rumor.
I can't. What about Nightmare Before Christmas? Do you consider that a Christmas movie or a Halloween movie?
It's overrated. Both.
That's a Hot Topic subreddit.
It's not overrated.
Whatever.
I love that movie.
Hot Topic subreddit.
Different topic for a different day. All right. So, yeah, I guess that can. What time are we at here, Pat?
An hour and 4 minutes.
An hour and 4 minutes? That's
24 seconds, 25 seconds, 26 seconds.
We went over some of the classics. We also went over some of our personal favorites. Does anybody have any final words or final thoughts on, you know, Christmas specials or anything like that?
I'm going to watch a bunch.
Yeah, I'm going to watch a bunch too.
Definitely watching the Bob's Burgers episode once I go home.
I want to watch this.
I'm going to watch every single one. I'm just going to watch all Bob's Burgers.
Just specials series.
Show's so great.
Yeah, I really want to watch the Scrubs one because I don't remember it, and Mickey's Christmas Carol because I really talk it up and I want to watch it again. But yeah.
All right, guys, why don't you comment or hit us up on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram and let us know what your favorite Christmas TV episodes or specials of all time are. Which ones are you going to be watching this weekend? And what are you doing for Christmas?
Yeah.
What's your usual tradition? You going to the movies? A lot of people do that on Christmas Day.
Yeah.
I won't be. You are, right?
Yeah, I'm going to see Rogue One again on Christmas.
Yeah, and remember to like, share, comment, subscribe on YouTube, download and rate us on iTunes, Podbean, Google Play, TuneIn, Stitcher, this, that, that. Like us on Facebook, facebook.com/AwesomeSundayShow. Invite all your friends to like it because they should, I mean, obviously. Follow us on Twitter @AwesomeSunShow. Listen to Live from the Middle Urinal. I'll give Phil a little plug. You finish out your plug, man.
Hey, guys. I'm back from Live from the Middle Urinal. Follow us on Twitter, Middle Urinal Pod. Instagram, same thing, Middle Urinal Pod. We're posting a lot of Instagram stories now. We're actually releasing our own Christmas special. It's going to be released on Christmas Eve. We're going to be recording it.
Wow. Yeah. I was putting this up on Christmas Eve, too.
Oh, well.
Ours
is going to talk about movies and toys and nostalgia, and I'm going to be dressed up as Santa Claus.
You are the Seaside SantaCon Santa Claus.
Dude, we're not going to talk about that here.
Yeah, I'm releasing my Christmas podcast on just follow us, Pornhub/property sites. Link, share, subscribe.
Oh, my God.
Nick Snyder, number one porn star in porn.
He's going to be the new Mia Khalifa.
He'll be like rap songs about him.
And then you could tell Evan that you'd rather sign an ISIS flag than a Jets jersey.
That happened to our friend Evan. Yeah, yeah.
It's true. It's true. I swear to God. That. It's true.
My finishing move is just blowing like fat vape clouds on like Jets. Oh, my God.
Hot take. Does Santa vape?
Ooh.
Mall Santa does. Mall Santa does.
Bad Santa does.
Bad Santa definitely does.
Any more plugins, Patrick?
Follow me on Twitter @RickPatMac.
I'm @LessonConnor.
I'm @HambonFacone.
I'm @TZoops.
You don't want people disappointed.
@SarahScarpelli.
Yeah. But yeah, just guys, from the bottom of our hearts, you know, we do wish you a very happy Christmas, and happy holidays in general, whatever holiday you choose to celebrate. Just to go off on, you know, just something I've been thinking about. A lot of us work in retail during the holidays, and you know, we see a lot of angry and people who you don't think really celebrate the season in the way that it should be. Be kind to your fellow man or woman. And
oh, dude, I was working Costco today, and I had some of the shittiest people in the world.
People are terrible.
I work at Best Buy, and I, you know,
and like this sounds terrible, but this one deaf guy was a huge dick to me today because I'm not even kidding. No, because that's great. I was packing his stuff exactly the way he was going, except his was like making noises and slapping the spots, and I did that, and then he looks at me, gives me the dirtiest look, and goes, and like just stomped away. I'm like, all right, whatever. And then these two customers got into it, and then people were fighting in the parking lot, and I was got parking my car, the front of my car, into the spot. I'm still pulling in. Had five people almost rear-end me somehow. It was ridiculous.
And
be nice to the people that work in retail. Don't be douchebags.
Well, the reason why I bring that up, too, is just I kind of just want to say something, is that, you know, you might not see the holiday cheer around the holidays as much as you used to, maybe. This year has been kind of a controversial year in general, and just remember,
Starbucks and their goddamn holiday cups.
Right, it's because that's the controversy.
War on Christmas that doesn't exist.
But listen, there's always something that is always hard to do, but is always as rewarding, and that's kindness. And you know, we all make fun of each other here, but it's always out of good fun. And one thing that we always share especially in our group, is just, you know, we're always kind to one another when we need it. And, you know, sometimes Christmas is hard for people. And it's, even though sometimes being kind might be the hard way to go out, it's also the most rewarding. And it's not just a reward for you, but it's a reward for the other person that might deserve it. So just keep that in mind this Christmas season. All right. And
wow.
Yeah.
That was good.
I hope everybody that listens and all you guys have a very Merry Christmas and Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays, Happy Kwanzaa. And just also be careful and take care of yourselves. And remember, it's always better to give to receive. And I know that's a very cliche statement, but, you know, don't expect anything, but giving is the actual reward.
All right. Well, I think that's a good way to end. All right, guys. All right. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Yeah. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And thank you to you folks. What about Anthony Dentino? What does he got to say?
Don't interact with Heinz ketchup bottles in Phil's commercial. Seriously. Hit the...